reason that it was designed was because within a shop with 5 or 6 men hammering, it was almost impossible to hear and understand an audible human voice without saying, "What did you say, huh?" all the time on account of noise. So that was when they learned that if they put their words into a tapped out coded message upon the anvil, then nobody had to listen for that human voice. So then long up in the 18th century, once Morse code was invented and the telegraph came about, then it became nicknamed the blacksmith's Morse code. And just as Morse code was a combination of dits and dobs, the blacksmith's was tapped and dragged upon the anvil. Each one of them meaning a different thing, just like the code, and then each group of them put together meant a different thing, just like the code. And even though created thousands of years before, they did bear a great deal of resemblance. But then, for wherever it was carried out here, that was where the work was intended, because the anvil became the hammer gauge to everything that was laid upon it, because this was the back of the metal, quarter way up, half, three quarter, and the end. Then it was finally in 1908, 1910, that was when our whole wide world woke up and realized that the anvil was no longer just a blacksmith's tool, and the anvil was thus adopted that day into the percussion instrument. And then you had the anvil choruses, which were made up of up to 50 anvils, all keyed differently. Most of your major orchestras, your bands, your symphonies all had an anvil. But to play one, sounds a lot like wind chimes, bells, hammer dulcimer, xylophone. Me and my three cousins, we still use this particular part of language.